another awesome episode. Guess what? It is Anzac weekend, and it's so important that we take a moment to honor all those great soldiers that went to war for us. So when you get a chance, honor them, think about them, remember what they did, and you know what else you can do? You can make Anzac cookies. We are going to post how to make Anzac cookies at home.
So guys, keep entering in your action packs and your challenger bonuses. These are the sort of prizes you'll be getting. You'll be getting the Dream Science, Scene Toes, the Slime Factory, and a drone. So right now, we're gonna go to Are You Game?
Hello there, hi kids, it's Dr. Crunky Crinkle, and it's so exciting for me to be here with you today doing the Are You Game. Now, Pastor Renee, thanks for having me. Hi kids team, it's so good to see you too. Now, I've got something really exciting I want to do with you because, you know, I really love experiments. I love anything creative. Let's have a look in the mystery box. Mystery. Okay, let me see what I brought in today. Nope, don't need that. What's this? Oh, colours. I like colours. Nope, don't need that. Okay, yes, this is what I need. Now, to make a sensory bottle, guess what you need? A bottle, correct. You guys are so clever. Now, what else do we need? Oh, yes, they will be very good. Let's have a look. Some baby oil. Oh, I love baby oil. Good for the skin, good for your hair. Makes your hair nice and shiny like my hair. We need some food colouring. Very good. I love food colouring. Don't you rather eat a cake that's rainbow than just plain boring? Okay, now, yes, I need a little container. What's in here? Some scissors. They're gonna help. Be careful when you use the scissors and don't cut your clothes and don't cut your sister's hair, okay? Glitter. Very good. I love a little bit of glitter. Can you see? No, stop it. Stop it. We need to get on with the Are You Game element. Okay, so first things first. We have our bottle. A bottle filled with water, but we don't need that much water. Let me just check it. Water's so good for brushing your teeth, washing yourself, washing your hair. We need to tip out some of the water because we don't need too much water. We need probably a little bit, about this much water. Maybe a little bit less. Okay, now we have our water. So it's a good start, good start. Now, we need to add some colour to our water. Who wants to pick a colour? Yell out what colour you want. You can have blue, you can have red, you can have yellow, or you can have green. Who says green?
Yeah!
Who thinks red?
Yeah!
Who thinks yellow? What?
Yeah.
Yellow?
Yes.
Or blue?
Yeah!
You know what? I think green. I love the colour green. Who says green? Did you say green? Yes, me too. Okay, so we add a little bit of green. Oh, looking good. Looks a little bit like cordial. Nope, doesn't taste like cordial, still tastes like water. This food colouring does not come with flavour. Oh, that is beautiful. Now we're on to something here. Sensory bottle. I'm already feeling the sensory, are you? Okay, now we get to add some little fun things like some glitter. We have a few colours here, but guess what colour I'm going to use? Green! You're right! I don't know, I just love the colour green. Lots of things in creation are green, you know. Like, tell me some things that are green. Trees? Trees are green? Yes. Grass is green? Yes, you're right. So many things are green. Where's my lid? Here it is. Okay, now we've got something shiny and green. See that? Let's put the whole lot in there, right? When I open it, here we go. Oh, that's beautiful. I like it. Wait, let's add some more. We've got so many fun things. Now, you can add lots of things to your sensory bottle. You know what? Some people even add Lego. Oh, beautiful. Now we've got the start of our sensory bottle. See that? Beautiful. Something you want to look at all day, especially if you're by yourself all day. You need some things to do. You need some pretty things to look at. Now, the last and final touch. You get some baby oil. You rub it on your... No, kidding. You don't rub it on your face. You put it in the bottle. Now, you ready? We're going to stick this in here like this. Full all the way to the top. Now, we're going to see some fun things happen with this bottle. See what happens. This is a little bit of science. And I love science. So the colored water and the oil doesn't mix. I don't know, they just don't like each other. They just like to stay separate. But then what you can do is you can mix it around like this. And something like this is something you might want to watch all day long. I know I do. So there it is, iKids team. How to make a sensory bottle. Why don't you try it at home? It's been so good to see you. See you next time. Bye.
Wasn't that fun, guys? Well, we're going to continue with our fun today by praising and worshiping our all-powerful, all-loving God. So right where you are at home, I want you to stand up to your feet. We're going to dance together. Come on, I can see you. Stand up to your feet. Let's do this.
Hey, everyone. Are you ready to praise God today? Why don't you stand up on your feet? Are you ready, girls? Let's go.
There's no
I absolutely love praising our God. I hope you had a fun time today. All right, this is our teaching segment. You need to do two things. Grab your action pack and find a seat because we're going to turn our attention to the screen for today's lesson.
Stories of the Bible. Joseph and his coat. So this is Joseph.
Hey!
You see, Joseph was the son of Israel and Rachel. Israel loved Joseph more than all 12 of his sons. In fact, he made Joseph a coat to show him how much he loved him.
Ha ha!
When Joseph's brothers saw this, they hated Joseph. One night, Joseph had a dream. When he awoke, Joseph told the dream to his brothers. He said, "Listen to this dream I had. We were gathering grain when suddenly my bundle of grain rose up and all of you bowed to me." This made his brothers hate Joseph even more. And they said, "You're gonna rule over us?" Then Joseph had another dream. And he told it to his brothers and his father. He said, "Listen, I had another dream. And this time, the sun and moon and 11 stars were bowing down to me." This time, Israel heard the dream and rebuked Joseph, saying, "Will your mother and brothers and I actually come and bow down before you?" The brothers were even more angry when they heard the second dream. Israel, however, decided to think about what Joseph was saying. One day, Joseph's brothers were working when they saw Joseph coming to meet them. One of his brothers mocked him and said, "Here comes the dreamer. Come on now, let's kill him and throw him away to be devoured by a ferocious animal. Then we'll see what comes of his dreams." One of the brothers named Reuben wanted to rescue Joseph, so he said, "Let us not take his life. Instead, throw him in the pit."
Yeah.
So when Joseph came to his brothers,
hey,
they attacked him.
Yeah.
They took the robe their father had given Joseph. They hoisted Joseph up and threw him into the well. Then they saw a group of men from Midian coming towards them. Judah thought it would be a good idea to sell Joseph to these men. So the brothers sold Joseph to the merchants for 20 shekels. The brothers then took the coat of many colors back to their father and made him believe that Joseph had been killed. Israel wept for his son, whom he loved. Meanwhile, Joseph was taken as a slave to Egypt to work in the house of a man named Potiphar. For Joseph's story was only just beginning.
What a great Bible story. That Bible story helps us to better understand that regardless of what Joseph was going through, God was with him. Just like with Joseph, God is always with us too. Now, let's continue to learn about how God is with us by hearing from Kurt. Let's hear what he has to say.
Hey there, I'm Kurt, and lately I've been thinking about one of life's greatest gifts, beef jerky. I'm just kidding, friends. Friends are one of life's greatest gifts. Think about it. They offer us laughter, acceptance, encouragement. Friends are a great part of life. And when we don't have many, we know that something important is missing. Maddie had been at a brand new school for several months, and she still hadn't made any friends. None of the other kids were very welcoming, and some even went out of their way to be mean to her. In the Bible, Joseph was his father Jacob's favorite son. He received special treatment and special gifts, including one time a beautiful multicolored coat. Now, back then, a coat like that was a very rare and really special gift. These types of things, all the attention, all the gifts, made his brothers very, very jealous. Joseph had also been given by God the gift of prophecy, which is when God tells you ahead of time what he is gonna do before it even happens. Some nights, Joseph would have dreams about a future where he ruled over the rest of his family. Now, sharing these dreams as you can kind of understand, with his brothers only made things worse. None of them believed these prophecies. Instead, they simply thought Joseph was stuck up and spoiled. And Joseph probably was a little bit stuck up. He probably thought a little bit more about himself than he should have. But like everybody else, like you and like me, he still wanted to be loved and accepted. But he never got that from his brothers. Eventually, his brothers grew to hate Joseph so much that they came up with a plan to hurt him. One day, when they were all supposed to be working, Joseph's brothers ambushed him and they threw him into a pit. And later on, when a group of slave traders passed by, his brothers sold Joseph into slavery. Then they took his multicolored coat, remember the special gift that his dad had given him, and they spread animal blood on it. They took the coat to their father and they told their dad that Joseph had been killed by a wild beast. You see, the truth is, we all want to be loved. And even though Joseph's brothers did some really terrible things to him, the real reason they did these things is because they were jealous. They wanted to be loved by their dad the same way Joseph was. And when they didn't receive that, they acted out in anger against Joseph. The details of Joseph's story are pretty different from what Maddie was going through at her new school. But they do have some things in common. We can't always know why people treat us unkindly. And no matter what the reason is, when it happens, it can make us feel like we're all alone, especially when we don't have somebody to stand up for us. But here's the truth. Maddie wasn't alone, and neither was Joseph. Even when his brothers sold him into slavery, God loves us, and he is always with us. Even when we go through times of loneliness, we can take comfort in the fact that God is with us and he has a plan for our lives. Now, the truth is, we might encounter mean people throughout our lives, but these times of loneliness, they won't last forever. Joseph might have felt abandoned or betrayed when his brothers sold him into slavery. We would, right? If that happened to us, we would feel alone and betrayed and afraid. But that was not the end of Joseph's story. And as we'll see over the course of this series, God had a wonderful plan for his life. So remember, even when you feel hurt or alone, God is with you and he will help you through those times. We'll see you next week when we talk about Joseph's brand new life as a slave in Egypt. Thanks for being here. Can't wait to see you next week.
Wow, that was such a good video. But hey, our learning doesn't stop there. In your action pack, there's some table talk discussions. So tonight as a family, or when you get a chance, get together, talk over those things, and let's go a bit deeper in God together as a family.
The Bible tells us that God loves us so much, and that includes every single one of you. And today I want to let you know that God wants to be closer to you than a brother. He wants to be closer to you than any friend you've ever had before. And the way you can do that is by praying a prayer and asking Jesus to be your best friend. And I'd love to do that with you today. Maybe you've said this prayer before, maybe you've never prayed this prayer before, but today, wherever you are, I'd love you to pray this prayer with me. Why don't you say these words after me? Dear God, I thank you for loving me. And today I ask you to be my best friend. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Hey, if you prayed that prayer, whether you've done it before or whether you just prayed it for the first time today, why don't you tell someone at home that you made that decision to have Jesus as your best friend?
Love God, and our
Well, guys, that was amazing. Great to come to you this week. Look, make sure you send in all your action pack and your challenges to the email below. Make sure you follow us on Instagram and social media, and we will see you next week.
Kids, there's three things we need to do together before we start our lesson. What you need to do is find a spot so you can see. Turn on your listening ears so you can hear, and close your eyes so we can pray. Now, say this together with me. Thank you, God, for this day. Thank you, God, for my family. Thank you, God, for my home. And God, speak to me today. Amen. Now, let's open up our eyes so we can see. Let's watch what's happening.
On your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. So much in the Bible for me to know on my Bible adventure. I want to know that God is real. I want to know how I could be his friend. I want to know who Jesus is. I want to find out what the Bible's all about. Hey! Do, 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 do. Do, 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 do. Do, do, do. La, 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 la. La, 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 la. La, la, la. On your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. So many ways that I will grow on my Bible adventure. I'm gonna learn my memory verse. I'm gonna pray and talk to God. I'm gonna sing new songs to God. I keep singing the songs all week long. Oh, do 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 do. Do 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 do. Do do do. La 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 la. La 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 la. La la la. On your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. Church is a fun place we can't go on a Bible adventure.
Oh, hi friends. Do you want to play cars with me? Okay, awesome. Let's do it. Friends. Did you hear that? I think it might be Shine.
Whee! Hiya, Emily. Hiya, friends.
Hi, Shine. I have a question for you. When can you pray?
You should go on a Bible adventure with our friends to find out.
Friends, shake your hands high in the sky if you'll go with me. Woohoo! Now, pretend to put on your adventure bags.
I know which picture passes will help. I'll give you some clues.
Friends, you and I will be picture pass guessers together.
Here's your first clue. It wakes you up early in the morning.
Friends, which picture pass is it? Great job, friends. It's the alarm clock. Ring-a-ling-a-ling. Catch it in your adventure bags. Okay, Shine, what's next?
This one is something you ride in that goes vroom, vroom.
Shine? I don't see a picture pass that goes vroom, vroom.
Oops. Can you put something on that blank picture pass for me?
Friends, what do I have that goes vroom, vroom? Friends! I think you're right. It's my toy car. Now we have a car picture pass. Catch it in your adventure bags.
Hey, that's it. Now for the last one. This is what you sleep in at night.
Friends, which one is Shine talking about? Friends, you've got it. It's the bed. Catch it in your adventure bags. Friends, count with me. One, two, three. Yep, they're all here. Now let's zip our adventure bags together.
Now it's time to fly!
Whoa! Whoa! Shine, I still need to answer my question. When can you pray?
The Bible has a story to help us.
The Bible is God's book for you. You can trust. It's right and true.
A voice in the night. That's in the book of 1 Samuel in the Bible.
I wonder what it'll show us about praying.
Hannah was sad because she had no children. She prayed, and God gave her a son, Samuel. She was very grateful, so she gave Samuel to God to serve him. Hannah left her little boy at the tabernacle with Eli, the priest. Samuel helped old blind Eli. He even slept in the tabernacle while Eli slept in a room nearby. One night, Samuel heard someone call his name. He got up and ran to Eli. "Here I am," he said. "I didn't call you," Eli grunted. "Go back to bed." Samuel crept back to bed. He heard his name again. Samuel ran back to Eli. "Here I am," he said. "I didn't call you," Eli sighed sleepily. "Go back to bed." After Samuel heard the voice a third time, Eli said it was the Lord. "If he calls again," said Eli, "say, 'Speak, Lord, your servant is listening.'" So Samuel did. "Samuel," God said, "can you be my prophet and pass my words faithfully on to my people?" "I can," said Samuel. And he did, until he was an old man.
Did you see that? God and Samuel talked with each other at night.
Yeah, God must have loved Samuel a whole lot to talk with him like that.
God loves all of us, too. I bet he listens when we pray to him.
I bet he does. I'll go ask Guy the Bible Guy. See ya, Shine.
See ya, Emily.
Come on.
Hi, Emily.
Hi, Guy. I've got a question for you. When can you pray?
I know that. I can pray all night, all day.
Does that mean I can pray to God anytime?
Yes, you can. God loves us, so he always listens when we pray.
How do we know that God's always listening?
My favorite book, the Bible, says so. Friends, wiggle your ears if you're ready to learn a verse with me.
I'm wiggling my ears. Are you wiggling yours?
Okay, listen to what the Bible says in Psalm 55, 17. Morning, noon, and night. The Lord hears my voice.
Friends, repeat with me.
Psalm 55, 17.
Psalm 55, 17.
Morning, noon, and night.
Morning, noon, and night.
The Lord hears my voice.
The Lord hears my voice.
Great job, friends. Now say the whole verse with us.
Psalm 55, 17. Morning, noon, and night. The Lord hears my voice.
Friends, you've got it.
Morning, noon, and night. I can pray anytime.
That's right. I love talking to God. So I pray to start each day.
You pray to start each day? I have a picture pass about that. Friends, which picture pass wakes you up early in the morning? Super job, friends. It's the alarm clock. Ring-a-ling-a-ling.
Every morning my alarm clock wakes me up. I can't wait to pray.
I'm gonna start my mornings by praying to God too. Thanks for your help. Bye, Guy.
Bye, Emily. Bye, friends.
Come on.
Ring-a-ling.
I can't quite. Oh, man. I know. I'll pray. God will help me. God, please help me get that ball out of that bottle. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, here we go. I can't do it! God, did you listen to my prayer?
Wait, hiya, Blinky. Uh-oh, Blinky, what's wrong?
Shine, I super-de-duper want that ball, but it's stuck.
Try knocking the bottle over.
I didn't even think of that.
Wee, it worked.
Yeah, but I'm still not happy.
Why not?
Because I asked God to help me, and I don't know if he listened.
Friends, does God listen to us when we pray?
Shine, our friends say God listens. But why didn't he help me get that ball?
He did.
Uh-uh. You helped me get it.
But who sent me here to help you?
Oh, God sent you. God did listen to me. God, thanks for sending Shine to help me get that ball.
God loves us, so he always listens, morning, noon, and night.
Hi, friends. I'm thinking about that ringing alarm clock. Ring-a-ling-a-ling. I can pray to God each morning when I wake up. Let's all pretend to be ringing alarm clocks. Ring-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling. God always listens because he loves us. When we pray, he hears us, just like our Bible verse says. Say it with me. Psalm 55:17. Morning. Noon and night, shh, shh, the Lord hears my voice.
Vroom, vroom,
vroom. Rizzlin' razzles. It sounds like something's going on in Mr. Music's singing studio. Let's go.
Vroom, 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 vroom.
Hi, Mr. Music. What are you doing?
Hi, Emily. I'm driving. Vroom, vroom. Vroom!
Hey, that reminds me of a picture pass. Friends, which picture pass is something you ride in that goes vroom, vroom? That's right, friends. It's the car. Vroom, vroom. That makes me think of our question. When can you pray?
I know the answer. I can pray all night, all day.
That's right, Mr. Music. But if I'm riding in the car somewhere, is it still a good time to pray?
Yes, God loves you so much. He's always with you, everywhere you go. God's always listening.
Do you know a song about that, Mr. Music?
I sure do. Friends, clap your hands together if you'd like to sing a song with me.
I'm clapping my hands. Are you clapping yours?
Okay, friends. We're gonna start with the part where we sing really quiet and get louder and louder. Are you ready?
Yeah.
I can talk to God.
I can talk to God.
I can talk to God.
Listen to his voice.
I can talk to God.
I can talk to God.
I can talk to God.
and listen.
Listen to his voice.
Let's do the whole song together.
Yeah, friends, sing with me.
Come on. When I'm in my home.
When I'm in my home.
When I'm in my bed.
When I'm in my bed.
When I'm in a car.
When I'm in a car.
Anywhere I go.
Anywhere I go.
I can talk to God.
I can talk to God.
I can talk to God.
Listen to his voice.
I can talk to God.
I can talk to God.
I can talk to God. And listen.
Listen to his voice.
That was great. Let's keep going.
Okay.
Here we go. When I'm at my school.
When I'm at my school.
When I'm at the store.
When I'm at the store.
When I'm at the park.
When I'm at the park.
Anywhere I go.
Anywhere I go.
I can talk to God.
I can talk to God.
I can talk to God.
And listen to his voice.
I can talk to God.
I can talk to God.
I can talk to God. And listen.
Listen to his voice.
I can talk to God.
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 And listen.
Listen to his voice.
That was great. Now, stand up on your feet to worship God with music, singing, and dancing. Jesus knows my name when I'm sleeping or awake. No matter what I do, he'll never leave. His words are true. I tell him what I love. I tell him when I'm scared. I tell him everything. Jesus is always there. I'm spinning round, I'm running free. I'm having fun, yeah, with my King. No one is like you, Jesus. That's you. My Jesus knows my name when best friends forever, BFF. Best friends forever, my BFF. That's you. Best friends forever, BFF. Best friends forever, BFF. Best friends forever, my BFF. That's you.
I was just listening for Shine. Do you hear him coming? There he is! Hi, Shine. We've had a great Bible adventure.
Do you remember the answer to the question, when can you pray?
Yup, yup, yuppers! Friends, say it with me. I can pray all night, all day.
Lee, and which Bible verse did Guy teach you?
Friends, let's say it for Shine. Psalm 55:17. Morning, noon, and night. Shh, shh. The Lord hears my voice.
God always listens. What did you find out about the picture passes?
The alarm clock, ring-a-ling-a-ling, reminds me that I can start each day by praying to God.
The morning is a great time to pray.
Yeah, and I can pray anytime because God's always listening for my voice. And the car, vroom, vroom, reminds me that no matter where I go, it's still a good time to pray.
God loves you so much. He's always with you everywhere you go.
Yeah, I can pray anytime and anywhere. The bed. Shine, why did you have me pack the bed picture pass?
Because the Bible verse says morning, noon, and...
night! Now I know! The bed shows me that I can pray to God each night.
Just like Samuel. He talked with God when he was in bed.
I'm gonna do that too. I can pray to God all the time. Oh, even... when I'm falling asleep in my bed at night. Shh.
Lee, let's pray right now for our friends.
Okay, friends, bow your heads and close your eyes. We're gonna talk to God together. Dear God, thanks for showing us your love by listening to us every time we pray. In Jesus' name, amen. Great giggling geckos, it's time to go. We'll see you next time
for another Bible adventure.
Bye-bye, friends.
Well, wasn't that wonderful? We learned so much about our great God. See you next time.